everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Ekta and today we're going to talk about the most frequently asked question during my one-on-one that people often ask me, that is how to find love. Now before we get started, I want to let you know that if you didn't know about my one-on-one coaching session, yes, I do take one-on-one sessions as well. If you're looking for some guidance, whether it's to do with your emotional health, your mental health, your relationship problems, if you're facing some, or if you need some tips for your personal and emotional growth, then you can always reach out. The link is in the description box below and you can connect with me there. Now, without any further ado, let's just get started and learn about how to find love. So when I talk about love, first of all, the whole meaning of finding love or having someone by yourself is so misconstrued because people think that love is something that you find outside. But love always begins with yourself. It's how you look at yourself, how you perceive yourself is how you can set yourself and get yourself ready for a relationship. A lot of times we want to find love because we feel unloved by our own self, and which is why the first step to find love is to know who you are as a person. To be mindful is to what you are and what you really like as a person. It's more about a self-growth journey. Because only when you know yourself is when you will also know and understand what you bring to the table. It's like if I don't know what my emotions are, what my triggers are, how do I behave when there is an adversity, or how do I handle my emotions during the tough time? It's pretty obvious that I will not be ready to present my best self when I see someone who's compatible to me. So the first thing when it comes to finding love is to find love within. It's time for you to love yourself first. You know, when I spoke about this love being misconstrued, yes, it is, because we look at relationship, we look at love as something which is extraordinary. It's something that comes from outside, but it often comes from our inner self. Let me give you an example. Let's say there's a cake and there's a cherry on the top of the cake. Now, if I remove and throw away the cherry from the cake, do you think that the texture or the feeling or the taste or the quality of the cake will change? No, right? The taste will remain the same. It's just that you've removed something which was external part of the cake. So oftentimes we give more importance to that external love, but we don't understand that you yourself is the cake, and relationship and love from outside is just a cherry on the top. It's a nice to have. It's not a must have. So it's very important to know that what you're trying to find outside is something that resides within. You know, one of the reasons why people often find love outside is that they're trying to get rid of this loneliness. They're trying to get rid of what to do with my own self. I don't know, and I need some partner, someone to kind of make me feel good, to make me feel validated. So first things first is ask yourself, why do you need to find love outside? Is it because it's coming from a space that you need validation and wanting to feel heard and seen from someone else? Is it because you're feeling lonely and you don't know what to do with your time, with your life, and you want someone else to kind of, you know, make you feel happy? Number three, is it because that you aren't peaceful and happy by yourself? You don't feel that you're recognized by your family members or someone like your friends, and which is why you need someone else to kind of make you feel important and give you that recognition. So you have to find what are the reasons that you're trying to kind of find that love outside instead of starting your journey within. First things first. If it's a pure purpose that, you know, now that I love myself, but also at the same time I want a partner, then of course it does make sense, because we are social being in the end and we want to have a companion. We want to have someone we can share our day with, our daily chores with, we can share our internal nitty-gritties with, we can share our emotions or our highs and lows with. So it's pretty normal to feel the need to want someone, but that should not take away the fact that you do love yourself, and someone else loving you is more like a cherry on the cake. It's more like an added advantage. It's more like a nice to have. It's a luxury to have. So first things first is to ask yourself, why do you feel the need to find love? If that's not the case, it's because you're lonely and you don't know how to enjoy your life, or maybe it's because of your friends trying to pressurize you, saying that, oh, you need to have a partner in order to feel good, or because all your friends and all your relatives, everyone's got a partner, and because you don't have one, you want one now. If that's the reason, then my friend, you are getting in a relationship or you're trying to find a love for wrong reasons. So first, fix your reason. First, learn to love yourself, love your life, and find the love within. Know who you are as a person so that you can bring only good things and best things to the table. So if you think that you've surpassed that number one tip, that's your number one barrier, that is you are getting in a relationship not for the wrong reasons, but for the right reasons because you're looking for a companion, then here's the tip number two, which is be mindful of what do you want. It's very important for you to know what you really want. It's really important for you to know your non-negotiables. You know, a lot of people don't understand the importance of non-negotiables. Let me give you a very simple analogy. You know, if you're going to a supermarket, I'm sure that you will be aware or you'll have a list of your groceries, right? What are the things you want to buy? What are the things that you don't want to buy? But what if you go to a supermarket not knowing what exactly do you want to buy? You'll end up buying those bag of chips. You'll end up buying those unhealthy cookies or maybe some unhealthy fries or momos in your cart. And then you'll be like, but I didn't ask for it, but this just came in my package. Similarly, in a relationship, when you're not aware of what you really want, you'll end up signing up for things that you don't want. You'll end up signing up for a relationship or for people that you never wanted to have at first place. And which is why a lot of people tend to, you know, get stuck in a toxic relationship because they come from a space of lack that, oh, I don't have anyone, but because I have this person, let me just settle for this one. But my friend, you are meant for greater good. If you think that you have someone right now who is not compatible, who's toxic, who's kind of affecting your mental health and emotional health, then it's time for you to sit with yourself and think through this. So be mindful of your checklist. Be mindful of your non-negotiables because in the end, you want a life partner, right? You don't want a prom date. You don't want someone for just a night or maybe for a week or for two. You want someone who with whom you can share your life with, your travel plans, your meal plans, your everything, your career goals, your personal goals, and everything that you've ever dreamt about when it comes to relationship. So it's imperative for you to know about your non-negotiables. In simple terms, non-negotiables are nothing but deal breakers. It's something that you truly, truly want in a relationship. Now, let's say, for example, you love traveling, but your partner is someone who does not like traveling. They have an aversion for traveling. Now, if you are in a relationship with someone like that, there are two options that you can go for. One, you can either make do with it, that you have to settle for it, but that's something which is extremely temporary. It will only serve as a band-aid on your aspirations, your dreams, your goals, and something that you really look forward to in a relationship. And the second option is that you will have to make sure that you speak up your non-negotiables and stand by it and create like a midway solution. So it's necessary for you to know about your non-negotiables as to what you want to sign up for. And if you think that your partner is someone who is absolutely not matching your non-negotiables, which means they are your deal breakers, then it's time for you to, like I said, sit with it. And one of the most important factors when you're figuring out your non-negotiables is not to focus just on the looks or the appearance, but also on the attribute, on the approach, the behavior of a person. That is, how do they handle you? What do they bring in you? Do they bring the best in you or the worst in you? Because to be very honest, in the end, relationships are all about how do you handle each other during your tough times and good times. It's how do you approach your life? What are the beliefs? What are the perspective towards the nitty-gritties of life? When it's about the little things in your life, how do you look at it? How do you handle it? How do you handle a crisis? So it's important to focus on these things, which actually takes me to our third tip, that is not to enter or meet people with the agenda of, is this person potential one to become my partner, or is she ideal to be my girlfriend, or is he ideal to be my boyfriend? Oftentimes we lose the fun, we lose this whole zest of wanting to meet people, connect with people, or know who they are, just because at the back of our mind we're constantly thinking of finding love in them, finding a partner in them. And which is why it's extremely important to not network from this agenda of finding love in them or finding a partner in them. But instead, the agenda should be to just have fun, create a good connection while you're in the flow and knowing them, who they are as a person and how do they handle themselves and their relationships and their, you know, their nitty-gritties of life, is when you will understand whether they are a good fit or no, whether they are matching your non-negotiables or not. So when you meet someone, don't have an end goal in your mind, but rather just be in the present moment. Just observe the other person. Just observe where you are at and what exactly are you into or what you're doing. And this will actually bring the best in you. Otherwise, you'll always be thinking, you'll be in your head, and that will not bring out the best in you. Which takes me to our fourth tip, which is to find someone through a common interest or a common goal. Say, for example, you really love reading books. So you can enroll yourself for a reading club, or you can get a membership of a library. So every time you would visit a library or maybe attend an event by reading club, you can meet someone who has a common interest in books, and you can find a common thread to connect with the person. Similarly, I know a lot of people who really connect with people with common interests, such as they sign up for a course or for a class, for some kind of a sport, and something that piques their interest, and that can help them in meeting someone who is like-minded. But remember, the goal is to have fun. The goal is to just enjoy the moment. The goal is to be in the present moment and just know people, network with people while you make a connection with someone. Which then takes me to our last and fifth point, which is ask yourself these set of questions before getting into a relationship or knowing how to find love. Every time you meet someone, ask yourself whether this person understands who I am as a person. Number two, ask yourself whether this person knows my triggers and understands my childhood baggages or the belief I come from or the culture I come from and is willing to work together as a team. And number three, does this person bring the good in me, the worst in me, or do they make me feel as if I'm walking on eggshells? And number four is, am I getting in a relationship or maybe am I finding love because I feel the lack that I don't love myself enough, and which is why I want someone to love me? Now, these questions can actually help you in understanding yourself much better, so that even when you are on this journey of wanting to find love, you will find love for the right reasons, as I said earlier. Now, I hope that you found this video useful, and if you did, please make sure to like, share and subscribe to this channel. You can also drop a comment in the comment section below if there's some specific topic you want me to create a video on, or you can send this to someone who needs to know that what finding love is all about. And I will see you next week very soon. Till then, bye-bye.